Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. Last time we completed the Not a Drill contract, giving us the first tick against the regional progress tasks. We're definitely on the home stretch in terms of jobs for the Black River map. The last scout mission we have is local entertainment, so let's get that one done. I'll need to jump into the Fleet Star and activate the mission first, but we'll complete it in the Chevy. This task requires us to reach 5 checkpoints which contain barrels to knock over. The Chevy is by no means a specialised rock crawler, and there are many areas with no winch points if the vehicle does tip. But there's no time restriction, so there's no need to rush through it. I was really not comfortable with the way the Chevy was heading here. It felt like at any moment it was either going to tip or slide down into the rock, but I kind of got lucky and was able to avoid it. This was another example of where the Chevy had started tracking in the wrong direction halfway up the hill, so in this situation it was better to head back down and start over. The last checkpoint is back along the river, and there is another scout trailer we can discover along the way. Even with low gear and with diff lock on, it's slow going through this water section. With that task complete, I'll take the Chevy back to the factory as we'll need it later for one of the contests on this map. The next job to complete is missing machinery. This requires us to pick up 4 loads of drilling spare parts which are scattered between the logging station and the factory. The Fleet Star is up to the task and we have a trailer attached ready to go. Trying to turn around on this hill with the cargo loaded poses a high risk of tipping the truck over. So I'll take the safer course of action and reverse back down. We'll need to offload the cargo we've picked up into the trailer, but it will be easier to turn it around while it's empty, so let's do that first. Thank you. The next two crates are on the hill near the logging station. This can be a tricky spot to turn the truck around, so again, it's safer to just reverse back up the hill. The rocks here seem to give the Fleet Star a bit more trouble than they do for the other trucks. I couldn't see that there was a rock being pushed along by the back wheel until it ran over it, and it almost tipped the truck over. With all four crates delivered, we've completed the missing machinery task, which is the last of the standard tasks we can do at this stage on the Black River map. Next on the list are the timed contests, and while we have all the vehicles we need to complete them here on the Black River map, we'll need to make a few preparations first. The Fleet Star hasn't had any upgrades since it left the garage back in episode 1 of this series, so let's run it back to the garage and install some off-road tyres, as it certainly has earned it. On the way back, I'll pick up the fuel trailer we left earlier, as we'll need to do some more fuel shuffling at a later stage. As with the White Western Star, I feel we're best to go with the UOD2 tyres for their mud performance. I'll sell the highway tyres as we won't need them anymore. For now, I'll remove the sideboard bed and swap to a low saddle so we can put the bed on the White Western Star. I'll bring the 5-slot trailer back with the White Western Star, just in case we need it for a later mission. I'll install the sideboard bed that we took from the Fleet Star, and I'll remove the loading crane for now for an improved power to weight ratio. We can use the Fleet Star to load cargo for the contests, but I'll leave those for the next episode. Thanks for watching.